Hello. Hi. It finally worked. Hi. It's Allie, and you made it to the tea. Thank you so much for being here. It is Thursday, which means it's almost Friday, which is when we go on Facebook Live, which is every single Friday at 1 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. And we do giveaways, we do Q&As, we hang out, we have a great time. And it's kind of like this, but in live format. So if you like talking about jewelry, you like looking at jewelry, you like talking about being modified and just having a good time, make sure you come. Other than that, make sure you just follow us on all of our social media. We are on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. Our handle there is at BodyCandy. We are BodyCandy.com on Snapchat. Then we are on Facebook.com/BodyCandyBodyJewelry, YouTube.com/BodyCandyBodyJewelry, and Pinterest.com/BodyCandy. This week is a round of Ask Allie questions because we've gotten a few really good ones again, as usual. You guys always ask great questions. And I just feel like they help other people that might have similar questions, even though it's not their exact question. I talk myself in a circle. All right, here we go. First question. Dear Allie, I have a weird question. It's not that weird, I promise. One of my favorite piercings is a double nostril. And the one thing I love is that they're pretty much even and equal to each other. But I've been to two different piercers and they both have managed to make them come out slightly uneven each time. I just got it redone and the piercer marked it in the perfect spot, but they pierced higher than what they thought they would. So my question is, am I just being too picky and wanting as close as possible to complete evenness, or should I just accept it and move on to a new piercing? There's a few things at hand here. It's unfortunate that you've had that issue. I'm not sure where you're going to get pierced. Are you going to an APP shop? Not every piercing is going to be perfect. I'm not shaming any piercers, but to go to several different piercers, you know, more than one at this point, and you're having an issue with evenness, right off the bat, like out the gate, that's not a good sign. There could be some issues with migrating and things like that that could cause unevenness later that wouldn't be their fault, but this is their fault. There's a few things that you can do here. Don't give up. If you really want it, you're never going to, in my opinion, until you get the piercing that you want, you're never going to feel that fulfillment. So I think that you should definitely like go for it if you're willing to do that to yourself again. But also, I don't know what kind of jewelry you're wearing, but have you considered different styles of jewelry instead of having matching sets, instead of just two balls or two diamonds, you know, doing something that has like some of the beading or some extra texture or a disc with a stud, things like that, that might actually kind of hide the unevenness of the actual piercing itself. Those are some options that you have. Of course, you can walk away and get something different if you wanted, but I hope that you don't have to do that. I hope that I gave you a solution. If you ever have any questions, please feel free to reach out on social media. I am obsessed with like ear curations and nose curations and mixing and matching textures and colors and all that stuff. So I can always send you some of my favorite pictures of some of my favorite setups if you need inspiration. Hello. My name is Lee. I got a nipple piercing back in October 2020, and I absolutely love them. The only thing I have with them is that the nipple piercings are always too small for me, the nipple jewelry. I recently bought 5/8, which I've heard they're the longest ones people make. Is there any way I can find out where I can buy bigger ones? I've had the ones in my piercing on me since I first got them, and I never realized I would struggle so much with finding the right size. Please help. First of all, not to shame too hard, but you shouldn't be changing your jewelry yet. It's too soon. October to now is not long enough. Nipple piercings can take 9 months up to a year and even a little bit further to heal than that. So first and foremost, as boring as it is, you shouldn't be changing your jewelry yet. Depending on what jewelry you're wearing, I'm assuming you're wearing something you got from your piercing parlor that's titanium, like implant grade titanium. There's a chance you could go in and get different ends if you want to change it up. Don't be afraid to contact your tattoo artist or your piercer rather and ask them that question. But when you do get to that point, somebody told you something false, because we at Body Candy carry nipple jewelry that's larger than 5/8. So there's definitely jewelry available for you. And you know, to go a step further, there are also tons and tons of companies that are willing to make custom pieces if you had to go that far to get something that was a certain length that you couldn't find. So you shouldn't have an issue with that in general, but you also shouldn't be changing your jewelry yet. I do highly recommend measuring the current bar that you have in, especially if you've already, if you've had them in for a while and they're comfortable for you, measure those bars and see what the length is, and then talk to your piercer. They could also probably help you get a hold of some proper length jewelry. Last question for the day. Dear Allie, I got an industrial piercing last week with a 16 gauge barbell. My question is, when it heals, can I use a 14 gauge barbell? Because that's the only size I can find. Thanks. Few things here. So 14 gauge is pretty standard on industrial bars, but we do see 16 gauge when it comes to anatomy issues. So maybe you had the right lip to have the industrial bar, but it wasn't quite big enough to handle a 14 gauge. Your piercer assessed for some reason that you needed 16 gauge. We are seeing that more. It is really uncommon to find jewelry like that just available in stock right now, because all of the jewelry companies have always gone with standard sizing. With that being said, again, your piercer is always going to be able to help you get jewelry that's going to fit what you're wearing. But no, you will not be able to wear 14 gauge jewelry, at least not naturally. And I'm assuming that if you were pierced with 16 gauge, it was for a reason. So you probably don't want to. So make sure you talk to your piercer, Lydia, and ask a lot of questions. I would ask a bunch of questions there. And at the very least, they're going to be able to help you. As I said, with the nipple jewelry, with the previous question, you could potentially just get different ends and swap those out for now. So that you have some options that are fun without necessarily changing your bar, or anything like that. You just got this last week, so you shouldn't be changing your jewelry for like a year. You got plenty of time. You got plenty of time, baby. All right. Thanks so much for joining me. I love you all so much. Thank you for always popping in every Thursday. It makes me feel super good. Don't forget to come to Facebook Live tomorrow at 1 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. I will see you all there. Bye.